Good day, everyone. This is the day 6 for the developmental reading, and we are on our lesson 4. So this is our first topic for our midterm. So here we go. So for our lesson 4, we have reading readiness. So first question, what is reading readiness? Okay. A child learns to read when he or she is perfectly ready. The people that surrounds the child, like his or her parents and teachers, cannot and must not push him or her into it, because every child progresses at his or her own pace, depending on his or her level of maturity. However, teachers and parents can do a lot of things to prepare the child to read. Kasi hindi proper na i-push mo yung bata agad-agad para magbasa. So, nakaka-stress yung pressure, hindi ba? And but then, maraming pwedeng ibigay na activities para ma-motivate yung mga yung bata na magbasa o maging ready sa pagbasa. Now, so therefore, the reading readiness is the purposeful process of preparing a child for reading. It also refers to the stage when a child changes from being a non-reader to a reader. Reading readiness includes encouraging or motivating a child to, tawag nito, read and engaging the child if he wants to read. So, in this stage, the child can recognize and react to sound of language and start to develop imitative reading. So, imitative reading yung nag-i-imitate sila. So, yun siya. So, pag once na nakaka-recognize na yung bata ng sound, and then somehow nagre-react na siya doon sa stimulus ng sound, and then nagde-develop na siya ng imitative reading, yung sinasabi ko kanina na nag-i-imitate or gumagaya siya sa pag-reading, though medyo hindi pa naiintindihan yung words ng bata, then that child is already motivated and ready to read. So he or she have achieved the sense of reading readiness. So, to proceed, how do we know if the child is ready to read? Now, according to Watson in 2014, suggested a number of indications that a child is ready to read. These include but are not limited to the following. Included lang to, pero hindi lang talaga ito yung mga reasons. Number one, pretends to be a reader through imitative reading. Holds a book the right way. So, hindi na baliktad yung paghawak niya ng book. Turns pages at appropriate times. Can discuss what is happening and relate to his or her own experiences. Sometimes, ang mga child or mga children, nagbibigay sila ng parang guesses or hypothesis. So, kung anong picture ang nandoon. Yung parang nire-relate nila sa life nila. Halimbawa, may nakita sila doon na princess. So, maaari niyang sabihin na siya yung princess and the queen is his mother. So, dapat prince yun eh. So, anyway. So, that's it. And then also, focuses on the print and realizes that it is conveying a message. Kahit hindi niya pa nababasa, pero alam niya na merong dapat basahin. And also, makes inferences on both what is read and seen in the pictures. Enjoy stories being reread and chimes in regularly. Likes to turn pages and knows when to. And also, the child will make attempts to reread the story from memory in picture cues. So kapag yung bata ready na talaga siya magbasa, meron na siyang parang knowledge or schema. May prior knowledge na siya sa sounds, phonetics, sound units, So kapag meron na siyang ability na magbasa ng mga words, so kailangan turuan na siya na magbasa ng sentences. And then, kailangan din bigyan ng mga activities or bigyan ng motivation or encouragement ng mga parents yung mga bata para magbasa. Halimbawa, may pa-bedtime stories, may time to read, and in my case, I am forced to read before nung mga kabataan ko, before na grade 1, kailangan ko muna magbasa ng abakada before makapanood ng TV. But then, it really helped me that my father pushed and encouraged me to read because as of now, I know how to read. Parang, ano, off din kapag hindi ako marunong mag-read tapos nag-teach ako. Anyway, to proceed. How to teach reading? So let's have first phonics. Phonics. So here, reading requires bringing together a child's knowledge of the sound system of his or her native language and the letters and letter combination that represent different phonemes. For this reason, some phonics instruction is essential. So hindi naman basta-basta makapagsalita yung bata ng ano, 'di ba, ng second language agad-agad. Halimbawa, the first language of the child is Bisaya. You need to first teach him or her the sounds of words in Bisayan context or in Bisayan style. Halimbawa, pag loto, English. Pero pag Bisaya, mangyayari, masyadong ano, matigas, luto. So, yun siya. Differentiate luto and loto because iba din ang meaning nun. So, hindi mo naman pwedeng i-anong sa kanya na, okay, nak, dapat nak, so siya lang yung mga ba, nak, ha, ang gamiton mo nga, ano, sa ano, ma, can you make luto na dasudan? So, medyo off din siya masyado. So, you need first to let him or her master the sound units in his or her first language kung saan siya komportable. Kaya nga, meron tayong mother tongue in the K-12 curriculum. Now, to proceed, we have the familiar words. Now, because they are fluent speakers, kids have a base vocabulary to begin with. Meron na silang prior knowledge of vocabulary, right? That's why learning how to read words they are already familiar is a good place to start. So kung alam nila yung word na medyo familiar sa kanila, so at least mas madali na mag-start doon. And also, this might include sa mga tawag nito, the usual na mga familiar words nila, yung name nila, and other concrete nouns that can be prompted using pictures. Halimbawa, name nila, Andrew. Alam na nilang na word na yan. So, maaari na nilang basahin yan. Halimbawa, nasanay siya sa picture ng cat, and then may letter sa baba. Pagkita niya ng picture, ano ito na? That's cat. C-A-T. Cat. And then, as time goes by, pag alam niya na rin yung paano idugtong yung mga sound units, mafo-form niya na yung sound ng word. K-A-T. Cat. Halimbawa, ganyan. And also, it should have one word at a time. Hindi mo siya basta-basta na bigyan ng ano novel agad-agad. Grade 1 pa lang siya, tapos binigyan muna ng Hamlet or Romeo and Juliet, tapos masyadong tragic. Anyway, familiar, it should have one word at a time because in the beginning, too much text can be overwhelming for a new reader. Make sure that there are not too many words on a page. And start by having them sound out single terms before progressing to phrases and sentences. Okay, so yun nga, one word at a time lang. So, one step at a time. So, ganun lang din yun. Anyway, to proceed. Let's also have ample exposure and lots of repetition. So, kailangan i-repeat ng mga bata yung mga words, diba? So, halimbawa, okay na, ano tanak? This is cat. Okay, follow after me. Cat. Sabi ng bata din, cat. And then, sa tinagal-tagal, pwede nyo nang ma-learn yun. Okay, so let's stop here on the ample exposure and lots of repetition. And I will explain furthermore on how to teach reading sa iba pang mga categories. Kasi medyo mataas na masyado. So anyway, for your activity as a new means of checking. As a new means of checking activities, comment down below your answer on this channel. Deadline will be on 24 hours from the time of this video, if it has been uploaded or posted. Question: if you are a teacher, how are you going to assess the child who is not ready to read but is already out of the age for basic reading? Example: a grade 4 student who knows that's with S, who knows the alphabet but can't read. So, see you in the next video on explaining the other categories on how to teach reading. So, that's it for now. Goodbye.